So do I get a couple extra seconds to explain the t-shirt? Since you, I like to make my own fun t-shirts. So tonight it's, I like big books and I cannot lie. It's true. It's totally true. I was going to comment on the not counting down clock. Damn it, it's back on. So I'm here to talk a little bit about the role of entrepreneurship in climate change. But to get started, we kind of need to talk and bust a couple of myths. So as was mentioned, I have the pleasure of running a small clean energy business here in Edmonton. And I'm going to bust a couple of those myths and hopefully recruit some people to become entrepreneurs in this climate change fight. So first off, profit is not a bad word. In fact, we actually really need businesses to participate in creating more sustainable businesses, because that driving economic force will help make the whole thing sustainable. That's what we're still going to have an economy to take care of, and making climate change part of that economy is part of the solution. So it is not child labor, okay? Two, it's not rocket science, or at least not always. So sometimes we think we can't get involved in running a sustainable business because, my gosh, the stuff they do is just incredible. Like, oh, my gosh, the science. And that is true some of the time. But a lot of times, what we really need is people who can help make our lives easier in a sustainable way. So that can be reduce. Remember reduce, reuse, recycle? A lot of it is about just doing things smarter. So don't feel like you can't get involved because, my gosh, the science. So now I'm going to tell a little bit about my story. No, this isn't child labor again, just saying. I happen to be the proud mother of three wonderful children. And this is a picture of my twin boys about 6 years ago. And I was in the midst of the absolute sleep deprivation that is multiples. When one day I was walking the boys and they were asleep in their stroller, and I walked by a house being built and they had a diesel generator running, and I thought, if you wake these babies, I'm going postal. And that is really, really what went through my mind. And they slept for a long time that day, and I kept walking. I thought, why do we use these things? They're terrible. They're terrible on the environment. They're loud. They're expensive. They're smelly. Nobody likes using them. So why do we use them? Why not use some kind of a battery system? So I talked to a couple of my friends in the trades, and I said, would you use a battery system? And they said, you know what? I would love to, simply for the silence, just to have quiet. But you can't refill a battery like you can a gas can. So what happens at 2 o'clock when the battery's out? I go home? Oh, geez, that's a pretty legit problem. So I thought on that for a bit, and I came back and I said, well, what if you could take that battery and you could just stack them up or swap them in and out? Done. It didn't matter that it was less expensive to use. The fact that it's environmentally friendly came second. They just wanted the silence. And I thought, whew, there's something in this. So I spent the last 6 years building business where we built something we called the Grengine Power System. And it is, on the small end, a potential solution for energy poverty. Small units that are portable, plug and play, you do not even have to be literate to use our system, and they're scalable because our energy needs go up. And if you're not already aware, economic growth is directly correlated to access to energy, so it's a really big deal. On the big end of the things, on the big energy use, we do industrial systems that have an energy impact that isn't measured in grams of carbon dioxide reduction, it's measured in gigatons. That's how big an impact it can have. So this was a big system in the making, and yes, I actually did go the rocket science route. But it was simply started with a problem that I thought, there's a way that we can solve this problem that is also environmentally friendly. So if you have ever had that idea of, you know, this could be a business, I could do something, then this is what I would recommend. First, you have to identify the problem. You have to have a customer who has a problem. If you don't have a customer who has a problem, you do not have a business. Don't start one. You will go bankrupt really fast. Or really slow. It's painful. Two, you have to decide, can you solve it profitably? If you can, then you have a business, okay? If it's going to cost you more than the consumer is willing to pay, you don't have a business. That's not sustainable. It's the apples. And third, and most importantly, climate change is happening now. So start. Don't wait. Start. So I have both good news and bad news. There is no climate superhero. There's no one technology or one person who's coming to solve this problem. But the good news is we have an army of everyday superheroes who can solve this problem. So please get started. Thank you.